Hello and welcome to Superpowers, the show where you can experience the extraordinary. And today I'm really excited because we have a guest who is a musician, and his name is Paul Luftenegger. And Paul has written some just incredibly wonderful, beautiful music, very heart-opening and very inspiring. And so love having people like that on the show because you know, superpowers come in all forms, and I think that people who can write and play music and express in that way, that's an amazing superpower to me. So I love that. And he is brought to us today through my co-host, Shelia Gale. And so I'd love to say hello to Shelia. Hi, Shelia.
Hi, Carl. So glad to be with you again.
Oh, it is great to be with you too. And I'm totally excited about Paul and you having Paul, because you know, one of the things that I know is a superpower and is wonderful for everybody's soul is music. And so please introduce Paul to everybody.
Okay, Paul Luftenegger. Now, first of all, I want to tell you how we met, because this is so cool. So I did a radio show and I interviewed Matt Kahn, and the whole theme of the show was self-love and how important it is to put your hand on your heart and say, I love you, I love you, I love you. You know, if you're scared, if you're afraid, if you're angry, it was all about put your hand on your heart and say, I love you. It was an amazing call. I got an email right after that call from Paul saying, oh my God, he had never heard of me or of Matt. And somebody sent him the link. He heard the show and said, you have to hear this song. This is a song that he wrote and produced. It is absolutely magical. So just take a little taste of this right now.
Put your hand on your heart and put your hand on your heart and say, I love you, and close your eyes, feel
when I heard that song, I just wept. It's just such a healing, beautiful, right to the soul.
Yeah.
Paul Luftenegger is an international multi-award winning singer and songwriter. Love Expanding Love is his new grassroots record, publicly funded by love and money sent to Paul through a Kickstarter campaign funded by his fans all over the world. Each song has a message for the world, like honoring the elderly and feeding every mouth, asking all governments to be kind, putting your hand on your heart and saying, I love you, and so on. So Paul released Love Expanding Love in more than 120 countries all around the world. His message is to encourage global love and kindness through positive, conscious music, asking beautiful hearts to get involved by creating a love wave from heart to heart around the world by word of mouth. And his international album is dedicated to Oprah, as a way of expressing his gratitude and saying thank you for helping him heal and move on from the tragic suicide of his father that happened in 2011. He is my brother, he is my friend, and a catalyst for transformation on the planet. Paul, welcome.
Oh, that was quite the welcome. My gosh, that's amazing, Shelia. That was amazing hearing that. Thank you so much for having me today.
Thank you so much for being here. It's just, you know, your songs, it's more than the music. It's your voice. It just gets to the heart of people, and it just feels so good. It's just amazing. How's the record doing?
Well, it's been an amazing last month. So it's been pretty much a month, really yesterday. So we're at the point where there's CDs on planes, trains, and automobiles is kind of what I've been saying. And they're going out all over the world. And it's one of those things where it's almost hard to believe. It's kind of like a pinch me, I'm dreaming kind of situation. And people are just going wild for this and ordering 5 or 10 CDs at a time. So it's one of those things where it's incredibly touching on a level that I don't even know how to really respond. So it's amazing.
It's amazing, actually, because as you listen to it and you start and you take it in, you can feel your heart opening. Isn't that right, Shelia? I mean, I'm sure you feel that too. It's just so beautiful, and I can't wait to hear the rest of the album.
Yeah.
It is, it's so important because it is all about self-love, Paul. Let's talk about that. You have such a message of love and self-love. Let's talk about how that song came to you.
Well, the one thing I wanted to share with everyone is that this song in particular is probably it is the one that's most played. It's the one that's most talked about, really, on this album so far. And the thing that's interesting about this, my most recent feedback came back from a women's shelter, and it was a therapist that actually was using this to do a group session, and she did an exercise with the people that she had together, and they actually all did this thing where they did all of these loving intentions on a hand that they traced on a piece of paper, and all of these loving intentions, and then she turned on my album and this song, and the entire room, she said, was gushing in tears. And it's an opening song for so many reasons that's very personal, because I know in my own experience, self-worth kind of used to lack in myself. And I think everyone has had that. And I think that's one of the reasons why this song is so important, because I think everything starts with loving yourself. And once you love yourself, you're capable of then honoring your cup running over into life. So I love it. I love this song for that reason.
Amen. Let's talk about your father's passing. Now, that was of course so tragic, and yet that worked as a catalyst somehow to kind of move you into the public arena more.
Yeah. So my father passed away on March the 6th of 2011, and I think everyone is waking up right now, more and more and more. And for me, everyone has a different awakening story, but mine was through the death of my father, and it was a traumatic awakening. And the thing that happened for me is that I knew instantly I had to face my biggest fear was losing one of my parents, and it happened. And it happened in the blink of an eye. And when you have a counseling session with someone, they always say that there's a new normal that begins. And what I decided to do for my father's suicide was really to honor his life and his legacy by what he lived rather than how he died. And I did that really by honoring myself, because I'm a product of him. And death is interesting because it's a doorway I had never really experienced into a new beginning. A new life review kind of process started to happen for me, and reflecting on all of the things, all of the dreams that I had that I kind of put on hold. And I started to just live my dreams, because I saw my father's dream ending in tragedy, actually. And I wanted to do something that mattered. And I got busy doing my dreams. And I don't even know how to explain what's happened, but it's been 3.5 years now, and we're entering the fourth year on March the 6th of 2015. And I know I've healed so much of my whole life from this experience of writing music. And I've always been a musician. I just kind of denied it for a long time.
Wow.
So yeah. You say you've always been a musician. I mean, you've got an amazing voice. Have you always enjoyed singing? Did you like sing in choirs and things growing up?
Yeah, so I grew up, I have always been in music. I went to a kind of semi-private music school in the public system for a Catholic board in Canada. So my whole kind of beginning, really for as long as I can remember, was being involved in music. And I auditioned for private school and went to choir and orchestra program as a result of that. So I've been in music my whole life, but I somewhere along the way, in probably about grade six, my biggest dream was to be a musician. And then someone told me that the arts didn't pay. And I believed them. And sadly, I really took that on. But I think having had that experience, it also makes me realize how powerful music is. And the thing that I love about it now is what I failed to recognize in music is that it brings people together. And that very essence, they say that people that sing pray twice as hard. I have priests write me this. This isn't from me saying this. This is from priests writing me. Mm-hmm. And when priests write you, I have to say that's an experience I've never had. And it's amazing to hear a priest saying that I've changed something in them.
Yeah.
And, I mean, this is flattering, beyond flattering, really.
Yeah, really. Well, you know, and you're right, though. The thing with music is that it is totally a universal language. It, you know, it doesn't take any study, anything in terms of somebody who's listening to it to be able to understand it and really enjoy it.
And on that note, you know, I've cried one other time. I went to a church, a Unity church one time, and somebody played music and sang, and I wept. And I'd never been moved like that ever until mm-hmm. I heard Paul's song. That there's something that is so special and unique about Paul that it hits your heartstring. You can't. It's not just, oh, that's a pretty song. It's an experience. Mm-hmm. You feel better. If I'm in a funky mood or whatever, I put Paul on and just play it in my house. I'd like to, if we could just listen to this, a little bit of this next one, which is just one of my, I mean, they just grow on you. All of the songs are just so beautiful. And this is it called God Really Loves You So Much?
This one's actually called God Loves You. But the message is God loves you so much.
So much. So let's just take a little listen to this.
There's a seed of love in everyone, uncover the beauty. Can be your
it just amazing? I mean, for people to just hear that, it is, you know, it's a way that people that are stuck wherever they are in the world, in their little apartments, in their loneliness, can hear those songs and start to feel better about themselves.
I have to say that's such an honor to even be in the conversation of that. Wow, thank you so much.
Well, dear, you know, it's so exciting because when Paul and I met, we just feel like we're long lost brother, sister, you know, and we have such a love for each other, just instant. And I'm just like his biggest fan. And he's also said that about me. So, that I'm my biggest fan. No, I'm just kidding. No, I used to be in the old days, but ego aside, no, Paul, you know, I'll do anything to get him out there because he's changing the world. I mean, this music is just brings people together. It's just phenomenal.
One of the things that's just happened today, actually, and I had this experience I'm going to share with you here today. I haven't shared this with you yet, but one of the things that happened is on the train yesterday coming into Toronto, I actually had this weird message come through from Bob Seema. And I don't know if you know who Bob Seema is, but he's a conscious singer just like I am. And he's been doing a lot of work in this arena for a long time. And we've kind of been friends a little bit. But something came to me where I actually wanted to work with him. So I asked him that yesterday, and we're actually going to start doing some stuff together. And the thing that's really cool is he also just released an album about actually kind of expanding love. And the title of this album is actually very similar to my own, which is so ironic because I didn't know that when I first started. And one of my fans actually told me I should listen to Bob Seema. And we've actually conversed quite a bit over the last few days. So things are connecting through music in ways that I don't even know. It's amazing.
Right.
Divine orchestration.
Absolutely.
All divine orchestration.
It's amazing.
Hey, Paul, so tell me a little bit about your process. I mean, I'm just real curious. Did you set out to like with an intention to write this sort of music? Did you say, I want to just write things that are very heart opening and that, you know, make people feel good? Or is that just where your heart is to begin with and you couldn't write anything other than to do something like that? I'm just curious what your process is like.
Well, and the thing that started to happen for me right after my dad passed away, I've always been with God. But what happened for me is I didn't understand what that was. And I had a call to write music for the world. And I had lots of visions as a child about doing this. Mm-hmm. Tons and tons of visions used to come to me when I was a kid. And when I did this life review process after my dad passed away, I connected with God in a way I've not connected with God. And there's a direct channel through my music with this. So when I write music, it's almost like it falls out of a place outside of myself that's also within myself. Right. And I always say it's kind of, you know, they say as within, as without, as sure. above, so below. Yeah. And this channel process, it takes a bit of work to kind of fine tune it. But mm-hmm. I have to say from when I began this to now, music literally falls out of me. And it's one of those things, the process is something that's almost, I mean, it's alchemical in a lot of ways. And I know that I'm answering the call from God to do this work, and I'm trusting and having complete faith in it. And I feel supported in it because of what's happening. So
it's
amazing.
Right. That's beautiful. And actually, you know, I think, you know, regardless of whether you're writing music or whether you're writing books or whether you're whatever you might happen to be doing, and that doesn't have to be an artistic thing either, but if you are feeling that connection to God and you're, you know, I mean, I've heard that we're all here really just to give God hands, you know? So if in some way that's what your daily activity in life is doing, it does come easily. It does kind of fall out of you.
Mm-hmm. Well, and I have to say, it's one of those things where, like you just said, it happens. And I know, you know, whether it be writing a book, I'm just reading right now Dr. Wayne Dyer's book, and it's I Can See Clearly Now. And the way that things are connecting and uniting, and someone just reached out to me and wants to put me in touch with Dr. Dyer. And these are things that are just, I mean, this is a personal friend of his, and things are just connecting, and it's the synapses are just firing.
Yeah.
And I have to say, I've never been involved in anything in my life that things are moving so quickly.
Mm-hmm.
That part of it is amazing.
Yeah. That's wonderful.
And that, you know, on that note, for everybody that's listening, because that's what we all want for our lives, you know, to be doing what we love, what we came here for, even though we may not even know what it is. I mean, a week ago, I was like, okay, God, what am I going to do now? I got to reinvent myself. And then I started to get in fear. And then I went, wait a minute. No. The universe has my back. As long as we listen and ask for guidance, you know, we're directed. Like this call today is so great. I love Carl. I love Paul. I love my audience. And I love, you know, bringing you guys out to the world. That's my thing. So for everybody, you know, it's just stay, have that faith. Say, I love you, love yourself, and God will guide you as to what's next for you.
And I will say this, I want to just share something with what you just said too, Shelia, is that I trip on this stuff all the time, and I get scared, and I get worried, and I go crazy, actually. And then I'm like, wait a minute here, calm down and breathe. And, you know, I trip on this stuff all the time, but I have to say the more you just become okay with where you're at in the moment, you start to just release and breathe. And I have to say, like, I mean, I get into fear sometimes too, like you just said, Shelia. And when that happens, I think the most important thing to remember is that you're okay, you're supported, and you're loved, and you're perfect exactly as you are. Just be.
Yeah, we're really built to do that, you know, and our brains are, interestingly, they are reducers of consciousness rather than creators of consciousness, you know, and they're like filtering all of the metaphysical realms and the spiritual realms out, and they're just focusing on, you know, on their physical perception. And so as a result, we tend to do the opposite of what my friend Ann Albers, who is an angel communicator, says we're supposed to do. We tend to think from the bottom up, which is we start with survival, you know, and fear. And if we're going top down, we begin with we're a divine being, and we're a part of God, and because of that we are, you know, infinitely loved and divinely loved, and everything expresses its way much more elegantly when we go top down rather than when we start with fear and security and, oh my God, how am I going to make money doing this, you know?
It's exactly.
Yeah.
And I really appreciate both of you. I appreciate, Paul, that you said that, though, also that you get fear, of course, and you trip up and you have hissy fits, I'm sure. I mean, I do too. Sometimes I go, what, are you kidding me? I'm screaming. And then but you know what? It's also that it's in God's right time. It's in patience. And I love what Matt Kahn says. When you don't know what to do, do nothing. Yeah. And everything will come to you.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
just stay quiet and wait till, you know, and it really works that way. Mm-hmm. And it's just, it's such a great example to show people, you know, whatever it is for you, who, you know, just stay with your passion, stay the course, keep asking and receiving directions. So
it's so true. So true.
So Paul, what are you, moving now completely away from, being divinely guided, and what do you see for yourself in moving forward? Any thoughts or visions or just inspirations that have come to you for how you continue this forward?
Well, I know one of the things that I feel very much a part of is that I believe that heaven is kind of held within your heart. And one of the things that comes through to me to share with people is that when you unfold your heart with the transparency of honesty for yourself, when you unfold it, when you create that externally, like we are creators. And that's the one thing that's, I'm very guided to say that. We're creators creating our life. Yes. And I think it's not talked about very much, and I like saying it as much as I can,
right,
because when you realize you're a creator, you recognize that you actually have your whole life that you've already created. Mm-hmm. Therefore, you're already creating your future in the now.
Yes.
And that relationship is really important to understand when we talk about our work, because I think it's important. And music's one of those things, it has to come from inside because mm-hmm. it can't exist otherwise. So it's a perfect example of actually creating from within. And that doesn't necessarily mean it's not, you know, it could be a book, it could be creating a light, it could be creating your show, Shelia. That's something that we all do every day. And your life is getting bigger and it's expanding quantum love. And when you put love out, it comes back. So I think when you create with intention, consciously putting out the love does come back. And you have to have patience, right?
Yes.
But that's it does get bigger and bigger and bigger. And that's, I always like to share that one thing about what I'm doing next, because I know I'm guided in love and I'm kind of trusting that what's meant to be will be. So.
Right. Besides the Oprah show, of course. And we've talked about and doing a live event together. As you know, Carl and I did the shift together last year down in Los Angeles. We had great speakers, and you mentioned some speakers, Dee Wallace and Tom Palladino, Rika Zimmerman, Patricia Cota Robles. Let's get Michael Beckwith. Let's do an event with Paul's music. So I'm just putting that out to the universe. Right.
There you go. Well, that's a great idea. And that was probably, Shelia, the one element that was missing from it, was that we didn't, we had speakers, but we didn't have music. And music is just, it's an amazing way to transmit that energy and that love and that heart opening that everybody showed up for the shift for, but they were just getting words rather than music.
What I love about, well, and one of the things I wanted to share on that too is that I love conscious music because it's a takeaway. So you can take away, and I think every time you listen to something, you get something different because it's yourself reflecting on your own self in that moment of now, which is why I love conscious music that way, because it, even today I listened to a Bob Seema song, who I love now more every day, but he was just sharing a song about his own personal life, about not getting too far into the future because you miss where you're at.
Absolutely.
And just a conscious song to remind you of that, so powerful, because I trip on that stuff too.
Oh.
And I conscious music,
yes.
You know?
Yeah, we all do. Such an easy trip up for us, and the closer we can stay to just this present moment, not wander too far out into the future and not go drift too far back into the past, but let's just stay right in this present moment, because that's where our that's where our experience is, and it's our point of power is right now.
I wanted to just interject something about what we were just saying about being guided and following our passion. And I just wanted to mention, because a friend of mine came over yesterday, Angie. And Angie is retired. She's about 65. And she just goes on in her world and makes a difference with every person she meets. She has no grand or great goals, but the way that she lives her life. So it doesn't matter what you do. It's the way you receive the mailman, talk to your neighbors, listen
Very
to people.
True.
You don't have to be a big music star or radio star or TV star. Just right where you are, that's what makes the difference.
Yep.
Absolutely.
We've been live streaming Marianne Williamson recently, and I just love how she talks about you can really know exactly what you're supposed to be doing and where God wants you to be. Just look at where you are right now.
Yeah. Can I tell you something? I have such a funny story that you just said that.
Yeah.
I just met Marianne Williamson in London, England, about a month, just over a month ago. And I actually met her, gave her this album before it was released. It was right about the time it was just about to release. She actually knew who I was, which is kind of interesting. And I have to say, I'm waiting to hear something back from her. But I gave her actually an album before this album was actually in hard copy. So I gave her my template for my original.
Right.
And I gave her this. So it's so funny that you do that. I love that you just shared that. Thank you.
Oh, yeah. You're welcome. Yeah.
Yay. Now, you just had just produced a video, or they produced a video in London, where you've moved to from Canada. Mm-hmm. Did you want to tell us a little bit about that, maybe?
Well, life is, again, the things that are happening are, I don't even know how to be who I am, because I'm just learning about it. But this man from Switzerland actually contacted me. And the thing that's so funny, I wrote him by accident. Actually, which is there an accident?
Right.
But I wrote this person named Max, who I thought was another Max, and turned out where he was like, oh my gosh, I'm going to come to London, England and film you. Is that okay with you? And I thought, okay. Because when something opens, I'm willing. I mean, if it's a love-based kind of thing, of course, right. I always say yes.
Yeah.
And he decided to come. He flew in from Switzerland to London, and we filmed for pretty much a full day. And he is the most beautiful, lovely human being that creates. So, and through him, he's friends with the Prince of Cambodia, And actually, so the prince actually then reached out to me. So I now have this prince who lives in Rome, actually, now involved with my music. Now I have this video to share with people that was really special. And to film it all around London was like, I mean, it was doing this was just, I mean, I felt everyone's watching and I don't know how to be that person, but I'm just being me. So I don't know.
Did a great job. You're just doing the dance, right?
Yeah. So going with the flow.
Take a little look at that right now.
Masters of the kiss are we, and masters of all that can be. Oh, thin the veils of heaven's gates, call the angels and the saints, forgive the hearts that hurt. And love the love, and peace will come, and peace will come when we love, be love, be love. And let the light of God shine in, hold the light of all that is be known, be known. And come together and love together forever. Love, we are. Time is on your side, I'd be blown on by the winds and feel the love within. Oh, God is all around you, and God is within you.
Wow, that really looked like fun, and you were completely natural. Oh, yeah.
Well, it was me.
Yeah, welcome to the party. I don't feel terribly comfortable in front of a camera either.
Yeah, well, and I have to say, like, I will say, I thank every single person in my family. Corey's been on film. He's very private, and I have to say, so I'm just very thankful to have people in my life that respect what I'm doing enough to be also a part of this to the extent that they do. So. That I get that because it is hard to be in front of a camera and you know, we're learning how to be this kind of hybrid, if you will.
Right. Yeah, exactly.
So, Paul, do you have like a band or a group that you play with, or is it just you and the piano? Or
so far, it's been just me and a piano, and it's really interesting because in a band situation, you have lots of people and lots of energy, and you know, a group or an ensemble. And I'm used to performing that way, so I'm learning how. I did a concert not too long ago, and it was really. I have to say it's a very out-of-body experience. I've never been on a stage by myself that way with just a piano. Elton John says it's one of the hardest things to do is just to play the piano and sing because there's nowhere to hide.
Right.
Yeah. So it was really intense. And I think, you know, to answer your question, I am going to just, I will sing and just play the piano for now. And I think in the future, I really want to do a 100-piece orchestra, actually. So that's my plan.
I was going to ask if you had, you know, any sorts of desire to have an orchestra, because it really, that seems to be like kind of the next step for this music.
And I play, well, and what I was just going to say is I actually play the cello. So I have a very strong string background. Mm-hmm. And I really, I've played in orchestras. I sang for the Pope in Rome back when I was 16. And we went with a 100-group choir and orchestra. Yeah. And it was amazing. Oh. I love strings so much.
Oh, yeah.
So that part of my music, I think, will expand even more. I love, Shelia. Like, when you feel that, I want to put 100 instruments of love behind it. So, but I need people to support me to get there. Mm-hmm. So that's, you know, by purchasing my album, by sharing it with other people, and, you know, answering that call out to people to help me get there. So
hey, let's talk about where they can purchase your album. It's right off your website. I think we have it up on the screen right there.
So what I was just going to say, it's available in 120 countries through iTunes. So you can go to iTunes, and I have quick links for the, you know, for the US, for Canada, for the UK on my website. And you can also email me, and I have hard copies to mail out that we're just mailing out actually all over the world. And my mom's helping me with that, which is really cool because it's a love-based business and she is a proud mama. So she's helping me and you're involved, and it's just kind of happening as it's unfolding.
As we speak. I also want to mention that if you click on the link that you see right there, ShelliaShow.com/radio, you can actually get a free download of the song "My Love."
Yeah, so my heart. Yes.
My heart. I keep saying my heart.
Yeah.
Love, same thing. Yeah. Love.
I'll tell you what. If you get your way down to LA, we could do something here, and it could be concert and live stream it simultaneously.
Well, let's that sounds like, I have to say, that's something that I think would be amazing. Thank you for even asking that. Huge blessing, and I would love to do something like that.
Well, this has been wonderful.
Oh, yes. An absolute pleasure. I adore
you. Thank you,
Shelia.
Yeah, this is wonderful, and so great to meet you, Paul. Bless your heart. Thank you for what you're doing. You know, just helping to uplift people with music, and you know, it's wonderful.
Well, Carl, thank you so much for this huge opportunity. Thank you so much. And thanks everyone listening. Thank you.
Sending you love.
All right, Miss Shelia. I love you. Thank you for setting this up.
Okay. Bye, everyone.
Bye. And that is Paul Luftenegger and Shelia Gale. And if you want to find out more about Paul, or if you want to get hold of his album, you can go to paulluftenegger.com and you'll find it there. And hopefully he's going to be posting future events where we might be able to even see him live in concert. That would be great. And if you are wanting to find out more about Shelia or the Shelia Show, you can find her at shelliashow.com. So thank you so much for tuning in to Superpowers. And if you like the show, please remember to subscribe. Just click on the subscribe button there. We'd love to have you be subscribers to Superpowers. And thanks again for being here. And go out and experience the extraordinary.